Hey YouTube, back with another awesome beer review. And like you can see, Stresse Brouwers. It is not their Black Damnation this time. Not from the Black Damnation series, but a new one they brewed. And it has been on barrels for 2 years on that Geneva. You call it the same in England or in the USA, if I'm correct. Geneva, it is from the juniper berries. It is a flavored spirit, of course. So it's been aged on 2 years. Untapped, I have seen, it's like an IPA. But I'm not quite sure about that. Only 22 check-ins though on Untapped. So I am the 23rd one that's checking this one in from the Stresse Brouwers.
Yeah.
So I'm going to read what's on the label. A holy beer, house ale, from Flanders, aged for 2 years in Geneva barrels from Deinze. And Deinze is a place in Belgium, of course, near to Ghent, rather close to Ghent. So it has 300 IBUs.
What?
18% ABV.
Oh my god.
18%, guys. So again, a strong one. And we have the same kilocalories here, 471 kilocalories. So I also search for the Tora Tora. And in the Second World War, Japan was attacking Pearl Harbor, and then the army from the USA got involved. And that's a little bit the Tora Tora, because I searched on it for it, and I did find a movie online that's called Tora Tora Tora, with three times the Tora, and it's about that Second World War thing that happened, attacking Pearl Harbor by the Japanese guys. And you can see it here. I think they are from Japan. Quite sure it's about that. Because these Stresse Brouwers, if they brew their beers, there's always a story behind it. Like, you know, the other 18% IPA I had, like Kill and Destroy. There was also with something with a flight squadron. And it was also during that period. And they started also from World War I. And they still, now, today, are still active in America. Those guys from the Kill and Destroy beer, they mentioned there on that label. So this one is again about the Second World War. So I think I said it all. Your juniper barrels, juniper berries are used to make this liquor, the spirit, like Geneva. Geneva, we call it the same thing. So okay, I'm gonna crack it open. I think I've seen some. There aren't many reviews, guys. There are only 22 reviews on Untappd. And Untappd is like a huge platform. The app on the phone. There are millions and million guys working with that app. And girls, of course. And ladies. So be sure it's a really new one again. And you know me with my Stresse Brouwers. My friend, he has them really quick. And that's also an awesome thing. Now, I think this one is going to be really boozy. It is, like you can see, it's here standing already like 30 to 45 minutes here. It came out of my fridge, but it's standing here a really long time. I already cleaned it 2 times. So it's standing a very long time. I'm guessing this is going to be, because it's outside here in Belgium, 26 degrees. And you must know when you're in your fridge, 6 degrees, if you let the beer stand for 45 minutes, it's warming up, of course. And like I said, I cleaned it already 2 times. So be sure it is like not that cold anymore, luckily. Because with an 18% beer, you don't want to drink this at, like said, let's say 12 degrees Celsius or something. No. I hope this one isn't going to be lively, and it isn't lively, of course, with the 18% ABV. I will use my Black Damnation glass, because I still don't have the original Stresse Brouwers glass. But then I always think, why should I order it from the Stresse Brouwers shop when I just need a glass this time? And you can see the color. It is like that ruby red, mahogany slides. Yeah, it's, you can see through it a little bit. It's just kind of hazy, but there's almost no head to it. Like, not even have a finger, but That's normal with an 18% beer, of course. So I'm really curious to taste their house ale. Is it gonna be an IPA? I don't think it's really hoppy. It's again like the Kill and Destroy. It's also called an IPA, but when it's in those barrels so long, you might get, of course, the hops in there if it's like an IPA, really. But I don't know who checked it in on Untappd, so on the app. We're gonna see. I'm gonna dive in. Cheers, guys. First on the nose. Those juniper berries. The Geneva is present for sure. It's all over. So I'm guessing this is gonna be a complex one again. And then you really got to taste it. It is malty. It has that, not that oats, but that, like the grain in there. And it feels like more natural also. And I looked at the ingredients and there are like different kinds of malts and grains and all these things are in there. So it's a rather complex one again. Spicy, I think it's really gonna be spicy. I do get some hops, but then like not those American ones, but more our Belgium hops, because they leave a lot of spices, like, you know, guys. I told you already multiple times before, there is a huge difference between the hops from America and the hops from Belgium, I gotta tell you. So this one also leaves that spicy note to it. And you might think already, there he is again with the spices. No, I'm sure this one is gonna be spicy and rather boozy, but yeah, I don't know about the temperature. I really don't know about the temperature, but I take my time. I do it really slowly. And we're already 7 minutes in, so this is going to be a longer review, but I do my best. I try, guys. I try to tell you everything about these beers from the Struisse Brouwers, and they have already multiple ones, like you know. If you haven't had a beer from the Struisse Brouwers, do try some of them. I would like to say, don't try the Kloeke Blonde or the Tom 8, because there are tomatoes in that beer. Those weren't good at all. The rest ones are nice, of course, really nice. And then, yeah, we have a Robert the Great. Like the Kill and Destroy, I also like, but there, some guys think like it's an awesome beer. Some guys will say like, oh, I don't like this, it isn't my style. I can understand it, of course. I think this one is gonna be a little bit like the Kill and Destroy. Some guys will like it. Other guys might find it too spicy or too boozy or some things like that. Maybe the barrels are too much in your face. I don't know. So we have to dive in, guys. We have to dive in. Cheers. It is hoppy. But really boozy. The alcohol burn is... It is, this is like, with the other one, the Kill and Destroy, you did get some alcohol burn, but here it is much more. So that's the difference for sure. It's still burning. And we know Geneva in Belgium also. It is like that spirit that when you drink it, I had it before. I really tried it one time. And it's like drinking it and it vaporizes all and you get this warming boozy thing here, like really strong, but the alcohol just vaporizes and it's really strong thing and really much grains in there. That's like all it's made of too, I think. And the juniper berry, of course, in there. But I would say try this beer instead of the real Geneva one, the spirit. Okay, so it is hoppy, it is kind of malty, you do get your dry fruits again, those things are the same. I do get a little bit of licorice in there. It is kind of sweet, but really boozy, guys. It is really boozy. But hoppy. It starts really hoppy and then you think it's an IPA, And now with the second sip, it is much better. You're actually used to the alcohol burn. That's a good thing. Yeah, is it really boozy? Okay, when you take your first sip, it is really boozy. And now again, I do feel some warmth, some alcohol burn here, sensation. But overall, again, I really do like this beer. But I can understand some people will say like, no, this is too much for me. I can't understand it, of course. If you are used to drinking, let's say Duivo or Triple Carmelite or like Guldendraak or something, and then you have this one, you will say, oh, this is far too boozy. It's really kind of off flavor. Or you have those woody notes also, of course, the woodiness in there. That's normal when it's 2 years aged in barrels. What do you expect, guys? So, okay, I'm gonna round it up. I think it's an awesome beer. The rating for me will be, I don't think I'm gonna give this 8.5 or something. It's a really difficult one. I do like it again. I will give it 4 to 425 out of 5 on Untappd. So it will be like maybe 8.5 even. I'm not sure. I'm gonna wait a little bit longer and let it just the temperature rise. Invasion of the fruit flies again today. What the fuck is happening with these fruit flies? You know, when it's warm, they are coming, of course. And even if I don't have any fruit in the house, but I have beers, of course. So there are some beers standing there, and yeah, then they come, eh? Then they come, and they do make a lot of fruit flies very quick, like they are pairing, like very much, very rapid, like rabbits. It's much faster even than rabbits. They pair. And they get together and they make children, and those children are flying everywhere in a couple of days. So that's not a good thing. So I'm gonna give this, yeah, I told you, 4.25, so maybe 8.5. It will be 8 to 8.5 out of 10. Okay, I'm gonna round it up now because you know me. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget, Beer Day keeps Dr. Ray. Cheers.